right, y'all, the grand finale. Let's see if the energy has changed. You done blocked, you done triple blocked. You put in for your divorce, your separation. You're tired of being breadcrumb. You decided you want to put you first in 2024. We can be here all day, okay? So now let's look, because sometimes the holidays, you can get a little despondent, a little sad. You ain't got nobody to cuddle with or somebody who really loves you for you. So we're going to look at if is there any new love coming in your life. Now, my past is yesterday. You could have met somebody at the grocery store. That's the past. So we talking about somebody new, right? All right, so let's get started. Look at that. I haven't even mixed them up. Somebody's in love. Somebody got a third party. Somebody desires some lust and sex. Loyalty. I'm trying to pick my card. I haven't even mixed them. Just want to do this in front of the camera. Somebody mad. Somebody just now recognize your work. What kind of reading is going to be? All right. Let's get started. Chose pile two, you could be drawn to more than one of my piles and call it collective. Let's see if any new love is coming in your life. One had drama, torn between two, twin flame shit. And let's see, somebody put you out in the cold. Somebody put you out in the cold. Somebody been breadcrumbing you. Punk ass promises and shit. Look at this. This could be a lot of online. This could be some crushes. Some lies was found out. Look at that. What's going on? Why? I feel like you feel sad. Do you feel like you're not going to have somebody really give you that true commitment, marriage, engagement, or relationship that you deserve? Because you could already be in a relationship. You could have a relationship already. But this woman or man's not acting right. It could be off and on, or you could be a crush, and or you could be, you know, side piece, or you could be the husband, the wife, the boyfriend, a girlfriend. I feel a lot of sadness in this pile because I don't feel any consistency. I feel the way the dating scene is or relationships are. I feel like it's just a lot of that energy when I look at these cards. There's some secrets being revealed. What's in dark will come to light, and I feel like you don't feel real good about it. I wouldn't be surprised. Like he was crying. Some of y'all could live in the cold. Some of y'all could be taking a trip. This could be an age gap, age difference. Somebody could have talked about you, body shamed you. God, this is pretty tough. Anything else? I do feel like this person feels bad, but I feel like she's like walking away. Like, I don't know if somebody used you, took advantage of you or something like that. Can we get started? What new love is coming in Pile 2's life? Seem like they all look like they all being done like this tonight. Yeah, I feel like you're going to get some, okay, now you got some good news. You're going to get some communication because somebody, it could be your husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, partner, right? It could be your ex. Somebody's going to give you some communication because they feel like you guys can make a great couple, right? This could be considered a marriage card. It could be a relationship card, but it's a power team card. Maybe somebody now wants to work, they want to invest, they want to put some time in. Let's, sit together and figure out how we could have a relationship. This could be a crush, this could be, a friend, and they want to take it to the next level. And I do feel like this person is coming with some communication, but they also coming with some penises and some vaginas. 80 plus dormitory ladies. Terry, stay focused. I just feel like this man or woman truly, truly desires you. I feel like it's going to be some unexpected sex. Look at all these wands. Wands, rods, and staffs. Be careful, somebody going to get pregnant. Not only do they desire you, I feel like you're a good person to have a relationship with. This is a pal. I can't pull no, I'm pulling my sex decks. But my energy is telling me this is going to be some makeup sex. This is going to be explosive. Sheer ecstasy. Ah! I don't want her. Because I feel like you guys know this person. Oh my gosh, I can't do my own readings. I feel like you guys know this person, and it's gonna be, you could be in an event, you can be as stubborn as you want with this man or woman, but I feel like you guys are gonna make up, because I feel like this person is gonna take it to the next level. So if you want to get engaged or married, or you want to work on your relationship, this four of wands, I feel like it's gonna be very illuminating, it's very optimistic. You're gonna be surprised how this man or woman treats you. Anything else? What else can we say? And I think y'all gonna have sex. A lot of y'all had sex already, and some of y'all haven't even met the person to have sex, and some of y'all haven't had sex. I keep saying sex. You're gonna come away with some sex, right? All right, yeah, I feel like you're this person's wish fulfillment. Look at that. Yes, you're the person's wish fulfillment. They've been thinking about you, daydreaming. They thought their life was complete, but now they realize their life ain't complete. Let's get it for you, pal, too. Right, you can be John the pal three. Ooh. You're this person's wish fulfillment. They're your wish fulfillment. Either you experience a town moment, they experience a town moment, or you're both dead. Somebody got betrayed, lied, cheated on. Somebody found out something. Maybe it affected this person. Something happened. Some financial struggles, bad investments. Something happened. It could be both. Like, you could have found out this person cheated, or this person didn't want you, or they had other interests. They're not leaving their husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, significant other. They had side pieces. You could feel very old, very too young. This person could have experienced some tower moments. Maybe you took your energy away and now their whole life is falling apart. Maybe the people that they chose over you or whatever they're doing, something happened. Maybe their livelihood, their lifestyle, something happened. And when you get a tower moment for new people, it's a catalyst. It's supposed to be for change. So maybe something happened to you, pal, too, where you go, I don't want to date anymore. I don't want to love anymore. Or you block the block, block, block. Or, you get what I'm saying? It's time to move on, or whatever. I'm getting a divorce. I'm breaking up. I'm separating. It's time for me to do what I need to do. If this is a crush and they're not giving you the energy, it's just time for me to move on. Maybe that's why you're looking in to get this new love. It could be anything. You could have found out anything. And I feel like it was very, very devastating. And you both could have. Why do I feel like you both found out something or something happened? I don't know if it's at the same time, but something happened where one learned a lesson and appreciated someone else, and one learned a lesson where they woke up and go, this person doesn't want me, so I'm gonna move on. I don't know why I'm saying that. Let's kick it. Why are these not coming out the way I want them to come out? Look at that. I'm talking about my nails, I'm trying to flip them, but they're not coming out. They want me to open them. Somebody experienced a tower moment and it changed you. I feel like it really hurt you too. Was y'all fussing, cussing? You sent a text, you did some block, something happened. But out of that tower moment, you see how this came back, I opened back up to this. Somebody made, look at that, you're gonna get some communication, that fell back out. Y'all see it behind my, hand? Okay. It's really fucking hard to explain, but something happened where it made a person appreciate somebody. One end up appreciating, and one end up getting a wake-up call going, you might appreciate me, but it made me feel so bad and so devastated as a man or a woman, whatever you found out, that I had to take my love back, my energy back, or I'm not trying to talk to you anymore. Where the one person went, oh my gosh, maybe they found, stayed in some relationships, bad investments, messing with some side pieces, or some hoochies and chicken heads, or some, you know, some men or whatever, and this is just saying it to make it fun for y'all, so a man over you know, or some other kind of man. But it wasn't what they thought. So this is the grass wasn't green on the other side. This was, I took this person for granted. My right foot is burning. This was, you know, they could have, why well, keep saying body shame and shit? Body shame, talked about you, listened to what other people say, but it all came crashing down. Maybe it came crashing down this weekend. This is past, present, or future. Maybe this is projected in the future. Something's going to happen where this man or woman is going to realize that you were their equal counterpart. You were the equal. You build them up. They could build you up. They, you know, they, you could share ideas. They're good at whatever they do. You're good at whatever you do. Y'all might be different where you're weak, they're strong. You know, the way I understand this card, for me to understand it. But I just, I'm hearing too late, right? Maybe y'all understand what I mean. It's like, okay, let's see what the cards say. I'm hearing too late because I just seen, I can't find the communication. And I just seen the four cups. Maybe they recognize your worth and everything now after. This is an after effect. Hold on. I seen the communication. Let me just tell you, if this man or woman was not trying to be with you or they overlooked you, something happened unexpected where they got to get their shit together because you're not going to be there anymore. Is this what all these readings is about? Yeah, come look at that. Because this man or woman fucked up severely. They're very idealistic about love, about adventure. They could be very, very selfish, very self-centered. They wanted to get their needs met as men and women. This could be long-distance relationships. They could have somebody else. Y'all could be off and on. This could be a crush. This could be a side piece. My right foot hasn't stopped burning. This could be, you could be very ambitious. The person could be very ambitious. Somewhere somebody was selfish and didn't recognize that you... Or you could switch it around, but we asking about you. Was their counterpart, and I feel like they thought everybody else was, except for you. I can't do my own readings. I don't know what pile I'm going to pick. But I'm going to tell you right now, I ain't happy with none of these damn piles. Because I ain't seen nobody new. None of these. This is a reconciliation pile. Didn't I say y'all knew? This is a reconciliation pile. But we're going to flip them. You guys could be very, very hard work. They could be very ambitious, and they was working on that. Look at this sword. It's just behind there. This is sword of truth. Maybe this person want to come tell you the truth. Because I felt like this person was doing a lot of lies. This woman and man was doing a lot of lies. What is this? And they spying on you. Gary Image. I could be wrong. Why am I rat-and-tatting on these fake-ass nails? They could be up all night thinking about you. You could be up all night thinking about them. Or you could be devising. Devising what? A plan to move on? Look at that. This man or woman is not going to let you move on because they realize that you're a person who they should be with. Now they're more willing to work. See, this talks about teamwork, collaborating, communicating so they can have a successful relationship. They're going to have to put some work in. And this woman... who did went out there and did everything she was big and bad enough to do, she realized she got this good man. She got a good man, a good woman who loved her for her. And now she wants to come back and get up under them. And I don't know what she was doing. Maybe she was freaking. You know, I don't know. I don't know. Drugs, alcohol. Maybe y'all had different religious beliefs. Maybe she was ambitious or something like that. It could easily be a man. But they didn't realize how good you were. So it's like this is the grass was green on the other side. And once they found out the grass wasn't green on the other side, now they want to come back. I don't feel like they eventually wanted to come back because I'm looking at the cards. I feel like they were doing what they wanted to do, but I feel like they took you for granted. And that's why I felt like both of y'all experienced a tower moment, and your tower moment was in the dark, would come to light. Maybe epiphany came off, and he's like, I'm tired of this woman, I'm tired of this man. And that was a tower moment for them. I think they wanted to be out there longer, or stay in with their husband's wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, baby mom, baby daddy, or their lifestyles, or doing whatever they were doing. Let me see. Any new love? Yeah. See, because you guys could be, I'm trying to learn signs, Tauruses. I'm a Taurus. Thank you. but you guys could be very loving, kind, compassionate. This is not my reading. I can't do my reading. I have to put it up there and see which one I'm going to pick. I'm drawing all three. So, you know, yesterday I could tell y'all, you know, which is amazing because I used to just tell what readings I pick. But y'all could be very caring and loving type men, very compassionate. This is the kind of man I want. I don't want a man so hard that he operates out of his masculine energy, that he doesn't know how to feel. Be empathetic, be caring. And you know, I was sitting there processing stuff, like, you know, nobody wished me happy Thanksgiving, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? You know, I didn't get no texts, no apologies. I'm just using it for example. I don't have anybody. I'm just using it for example so y'all can understand what I mean. And that's what I want. I want a man who's thoughtful and caring. Or when I say that I lost my YouTube channel, you know, oh, I'm sorry to hear that. It's not always about you. Let me be the first one to like and subscribe. You get what I'm saying? Maybe y'all channeling what I'm saying. So that's how the Empress is, like very caring, loving. And then she has good character. And character is what you do when nobody's around. So if you're going to be a nice person and you're going to be loving, you're going to be like that in public, in the club, at the gig, at the gala, at the golf course, in the work environment, you know what I mean, in the gym, you know what I mean, at church, at the mall, you know, on the college campus, around your friends. You get what I'm saying? Because that's what character is. It's not when you get with your friends, or, you know, you think you're better, or you think you're, you know, superior, or you're ashamed of me, or you're not, or you want to do things to get people's attention just to, you know, 13:33 o'clock, you know, because you're showing off. This is how beautiful, pal, too, you guys are. You're the Empress. As men and women, you operate out of that feminine energy, which you could be very, you could be psychic, or, you know, you could even be a tarot card reader, psychic, something like that. But you have this king intuition. You feel, you care, you're compassionate, you're very motivating, very understanding, very loving. But then she can also check your ass, and she does it with love. You know what I'm saying? Get your shit together. You know what I'm saying? You're doing drugs, you're doing alcohol, too much sex. You know, you're being very nasty, you're very cold. And maybe, and I went off on a tangent, maybe you want a man or woman who is balanced, which you should. They're not operating on so much masculine energy where they know how to feel and be emotionally available, right? So I'll put that there. And maybe this person realized how caring, but she's also forgiving. Let me see. Who's coming in your life for a new fuckboy? Fuckboy, fuck girl, player. Does a player and an empress need to be together? Get the fuck out of here. Look at that. Can you give me some more information on a fuck boy and a fuck girl? Can I know why? I got to know. Get the hell away. Oh, did y'all see it fall upside down? Because they put you out in the cold. They put you out in the cold. They breadcrumb you. They seduced you. They gave you mixed signals. They turned you on. Some of them, they were engaged to you. That's all you is engagement. Or they didn't want to marry you. Or they didn't want to establish some kind of relationship. Or long term. Or they looked at you as friends with benefits. Situation shits. Entanglements. Maybe they talked about you. Something like that. But this came upside down. So I feel like this. And I asked, why this fuck boy here, right? Or fuck girl. Player. Play it. Whatever. Bachelorette. Non-committal type. Just want to have sex. Hit it. Quit it. Have different conquer and conquest. It came upside down because this person just realized who you were. What kind of man you and woman you are. You're the Empress. And I just went through that whole story about wanting somebody emotionally unavailable. They're probably being convicted now. They're probably feeling very, very bad. So, pal two, I am so sorry. The person coming in your life is a person that you do not want to fucking be bothered with. I'm reading the spiritual world now. You have a right and you have a will to say, please get the hell out of my face to a man or a woman. You can block, double block, triple block, and you can go anywhere they're not at. But at the end of the day, I'm reading the spiritual cards and they see stuff that we don't see. Whether they're aliens or whatever. And they're saying this man or woman, this player, is trying to come back in your life. Now, you know, you can block somebody. They can use somebody else's phone. Or they can use somebody's phone, leave a voicemail, leave something very romantic on there. Say they sorry. Why am I channeling all this bullshit? You know what I'm saying? You might meet them out or whatever. This is a pile where you can run from this woman or man. But they're gonna plead their case. And the Five of Pentacles upside down is because they realize that they fucked up a good thing. Who dogs the Empress? So it's somebody you know. Don't worry, I'm getting rid of this shit. Anything else? Yes. They just contemplating what they gonna do next. They think so. Oh God. This person feel like they own you, possess you. They're not letting you go. They're not letting you go. They realize they was cold and emotionally unavailable. They realize they were juggling you. This, I told you, it's a lot of sex. Person has a physical desire you. They desire you, period. They want you. Be careful, I said period. This person might look at that tower moment. They experienced the tower moment. They was juggling them people. People probably the one gave it to them and shit. They've been doing some thinking. There you go. Y'all probably didn't even care if they got karma, because I don't feel like y'all care about this person. Yeah. They want to start a new beginning. I said that. Ace of Pentacles. They want to start a new beginning. Justice card. They've been getting it. The Justice card talks about like karma. So just think about it. This person is getting, you seen these tower moments, they're catching hell. If they're not catching nothing, then their life is good. When they off to themselves, their heart and their mind and their spirit cannot sit still. They're restless. They're because they're being convicted. Even if they're having a perfect life and they stayed with their husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, side pieces, pick somebody else over you, my right foot is burning. So they could be at birthday parties. I don't care. They could be at weddings. They could be wherever they're at, you know, walking across the stage, graduate from college. They're not sitting right because they feel like they didn't do you right. If you didn't do the Empress, y'all, you're in color purple. Everything you touch gonna fail. Basically, I don't own the rights to that. You didn't do the Empress right? The Empress, the birth of nations, of the world, of the universe. You know, I'm exaggerating, but I'm just saying, you didn't do, and they feel really bad, and now they want to plant a seed. They want to start over. They want to start over, right? Let's kick these. I know that's not what you want to hear. I feel you. Oh, they're contemplating on what they need to do. It's a contemplation card. They're a little nervous and a little scared, but they're not that scared. Normally, I get it where they're scared. I don't feel that energy. I just feel like they're going to just call you, text you, come see you, and say, fuck it. Because this is a test. Either they can win or lose with you. And I just feel like they ain't got nothing to lose, because I feel like y'all walked away and said, fuck them, fuck you. Or, I'm tired of this shit. I'm tired of relationships. A lot of long distance in this, too. So they got to do all the work. Let's see these. Who's coming in? Somebody you know. What the fuck? Five of Herb. Somebody played you close. Somebody that breadcrumbed you. She got her clothes on. They can't report that. Somebody that breadcrumbed you. Somebody, I'm trying to show y'all your card. You just had this card. Somebody who really, what the fuck? I mean, they really, really try to really play you close. Look at that. They really try to breadcrumbing, gaslighting, manipulate, use you. Friends with benefits, didn't really take you seriously. Wasn't thinking about you for long term. And then you get it for here, for these cards too. Even if this is for sex. They just wanted to have sex. They didn't want to have no real relationship. And now they feel bad because they did this to the Empress. Fuck. Hey, you want me to say it for you? Fuck you. You don't deserve me. I can't tell y'all what to do. This don't feel like I have my whole deck. At all. Drop some cards in my basket. I'm pretty positive. Who's coming in your life? I wonder why y'all had me do that. Anything happen in the reading? Who coming in their life? Somebody that breadcrumbs you. Anything else? Who coming in their life? God, dog. Five of water. You know what? That's some fucked up shit. These are sex cards. Five of water is regret. This person regret, and they got the justice card. They could have just been wanting to hit it and quit it, or just have sex with you, keep you as a side piece, or some of y'all haven't had sex with this person or not. Some of y'all could be virgins or haven't had sex for a long time, because he's looking at her private area. I'm not going to show this card, but I will show you that's five of water, in case somebody don't believe that. It's basically five of chalice, five of cups. This person has a lot of regret. I can't tell grown folk what to do, but I'm going to say fuck this person. Fuck that. That's all they seen the Empress for. You got the five of water and the five of earth. God, dog. Fives ain't good. I learned that from Beautiful Place Tara. Hi, Laddie. Fucked up. You could have found out some stuff about this person and walked away from this person. I don't blame you. I can't tell y'all. Why am I sober? Somber. Somebody could drink. Look at him. Don't he look all drunk? Looking like a hobo. Somebody could act out their element, do drugs. They don't have to drink or do drugs. They could get around people and act like they don't know you. You ever see people like that? Ah. But I got this for swords, so they've been thinking. Let's get a music card so I can cut this shit off because I said I didn't want to do these type of readings. It's the same shit. It's reconciliation with somebody. Now, I don't see nobody new in the energy in here, but that don't mean that you don't go out there and date, or you doing what you're doing, or some of y'all are already in relationships. You could still be pining for your twin flame or something like that. Or crush, you do what you want. You're growing. I'm just reading the cards with the anxious see that we can't see. And what I'm telling you is that somebody did y'all fucking wrong, too. They took advantage. They did y'all wrong. They took you for granted. Either pick somebody else over you. They stay with somebody. Or even if they say they single and they messing with somebody else and they really are, but then they even pick somebody else over you. Like, they didn't want to invest in you. You wasn't supposed to be long term, and they feel really, really bad. Fuck them. Fuck them. Like I said, it could be your husband, could be your boyfriend, girlfriend, significant other, and they said they're gonna invest in you, and they ain't really trying to invest shit. Now they want to, and they feel bad. They got a lot of regrets how they did you as a man or woman. Anything else? That's one. They got a lot of fucking regrets. Lauryn Hill, can't take my eyes off of you. You're just too good to be true. Y'all, it's the Empress. The Empress is a good man. It's a good woman. We just went through that. The good character. Now they see your goodness. Ain't a fucked up shit. I'm gonna pull this because I'm feeling it. Lauryn Hill. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You be like heaven to touch. I want to hold you so much. A lot of y'all haven't even had sex with this person. Maybe not even kissed them. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes. Somebody could have got a health scare. Somebody could have got an STD. Scared the shit out of them. Somebody, maybe a life scare. Somebody just realized how important you are. Somebody could be getting older. Somebody could, I don't know. Whatever. Somebody just realized that you're a heaven sent as a man or woman, and they're just really glad. It's not about, I'm thankful to God I'm alive. I feel like they're really glad that they made the connection that before it's too late, so they can create some memories with you. You can do what you want to do. Genuine differences. My whole life has changed since you came in. I knew back then you were that special one. I'm so in love, so deep in love. You make my life complete. You are so sweet. No one competes. Glad you came into my life. You blind me with your love. With you, I have no sight. This person didn't. I told you, you could be very different. They could have different beliefs, different sizes, their different preferences. They could have been listening to somebody. Somewhere there's different lifestyle, something like that. I feel like this person chose somebody else over you, or they just didn't even pay attention to you, or they just this man or woman just want to have sex, or just take your money, or use you, or make other people jealous. Like, they didn't plan anything for you. But, and I feel like they wasn't even expecting you to come in their life. So this could be kind of a new relationship, or it could be an old relationship. Relationship, y'all rekindled it, y'all got back together, but they didn't take you seriously because I don't like to put time on my readings. But since you came into their life, I knew back then, like a lot of y'all could have known it from college, high school. Back then could be 2 or 3 months because, time is not quantified, but they knew that you were special. Maybe you wanted to be special and they didn't make you special. Now they knew that you were special. They could have played hard and operated out of their pride and their ego and didn't let you know how much they love you and care about you, this man or woman. But now they're so deep in love with you. You make their life complete. So that means they make you compete, whether you know it or not, against other men and other women, which is a fucked up situation. And that doesn't make you feel good. That makes you have a sense of rejection, or you know what I mean, or I'm never gonna be good enough because I gotta look a certain way, act a certain way, be a certain way. You get what I'm saying? And so, why do I feel? Was this time moments? Why do I feel like you have to push back off this man or woman? And it says that you make my life complete. You are so sweet. You could be very kind and nice and loving, and caring. Men and women, why do I feel like this man or woman projects a lot on you? And maybe they started realizing that they are the problem. And you know what I'm saying? Then they realize how sweet and kind you are. I'm glad you came into my life. I feel like hindsight, being 2020, now they realize the gift that they were given, the Empress. You blind me with your love. I feel like now they don't look at preferences. Some of y'all could be plus sizes. You could be a different race, culture, ethnic group. Now they don't look at whatever their preferences is blinded. The only thing they see is your heart, your spirit. with you, I have no sight, meaning they don't look at all those things that they don't look at all the disadvantages that would keep you apart, because this person, like, they could find something, this man or woman, now they just thinks with their heart and their spirit, because I feel like this is divinely ordered. All right, y'all, so I'm sorry, somebody that you know that wants to reconcile with you, that's going to try really, really hard, that's facing a lot of karma, that's being convicted, what's in the dark will come to light, they had to lose you. You know, and it's up to you if you want them back. You know, I know our tarot card readers tell people, some, don't go back. I don't tell anybody that, because when you love somebody, your heart pines for somebody. You don't know what you're going to do, right? But today, you might say, fuck you. I ain't thinking next, right? And tomorrow, you might be like, I don't